Welcome everyone. In this lecture, we are going to see one of the wave shaping circuit, which is a precision rectifier circuit. How this rectifier is different from a regular, or we can say that a silicon rectifier is. We know that in the silicon rectifier circuit, we are using a silicon diode, so that for the cut-in voltage of silicon diode is 0.7 volt. And the input voltages which are greater than 0.7 volt will be rectified by the silicon rectifier circuits. So this is one of the disadvantage of the silicon rectifier, that we could not rectify the small signals or the signals which are in the range of millivolt signals or microwave signals. So for the rectification of millivolt or microvolt signals, we are using the precision rectifiers. Okay, so this is nothing but for small signal rectification we are using precision rectifier, and it is designed with the help of an operational amplifier and rectifiers. Okay, so there are basically two types of rectifiers. One is half wave rectifier and another is full wave rectifier. So initially we will see about a precision half wave rectifier. So we are using the inverting configuration of the operational amplifier. We have used inverting configuration of op amp, to which the signal, which is a small signal in the range of millivolt or microvolt, we are providing as input to the inverting input terminal of op amp. One diode D1 is connected in the feedback network, and another diode D2 is also connected to the output, that at point A. Okay, so now we consider here how the circuit will work and how the signal will get rectified at the output. Initially, when we consider that input is provided for the positive half cycle, what happens, as this is the inverting configuration, for positive half cycle as the input, we got output is negative. Okay, so at point A output is negative, and this is sufficiently large enough to make diode D1 in forward bias. So whenever diode voltage at this point is a negative voltage for positive half cycle, diode D1 is in forward bias, and this diode conducts, and because of which it will closes the feedback path. So there is no any current or voltage that has to be flow through the feedback resistor RF. And this negative voltage make diode D2 in reverse bias condition. So output voltage available here will be zero. So there is no output voltage available. So diode will conduct, D1 will conduct, and op amp is having input voltage. And V0 dash voltage is nothing but minus 0.7 volt. What is it? Is because voltage drop across diode is 0.7 volt. So voltage at point A, that is V0A, is minus 0.7 volt. So this is the case when input signal is positive half cycle. So output voltage V0 that we are plotting here is zero. There is no output voltage. Now consider the negative half cycle of input signal. For the negative half cycle, as we are providing to the inverting input terminal, output is positive. And this will make diode D2 in forward bias. This will closes the feedback path, and this will make feedback resistor into the circuit. So there is some current flowing through the feedback resistor. Now here the output voltage is nothing but output voltage of inverting amplifier, and that is simply minus RF by R1, which is gain of the inverting amplifier, into input voltage Vin. Okay, we know that as initially for the first positive half cycle, here is some voltage minus 0.7 volt. Now this voltage is available at here. So the cut-in voltage of 0.7 volt, which will clears this minus 0.7 volt, and this diode will conduct from 0 volt. So now we have to select these resistors RF and R1 such that output voltage V0 is equal to minus of Vin. That is, for RF is equal to R1, this will have gain is equal to 1, and this will conduct the input at the output. So output voltage V0, that is negative half cycle, will be rectified, and we got the positive half cycle at the output. Okay, in this way this inverting half wave rectifier will work. That is, For the one complete cycle of input signal, only one half cycle will get rectified. Okay, this is for the inverting precision half wave rectifier. How the again in the same way we can also design the non-inverting half wave rectifier. That is, for this we have connected input signal. So you can connect here sinusoidal input signal, which is in the range of millivolt, microvolt, Vin voltage. So when we are connecting this Vin voltage to the non-inverting input terminal, and one of the diode is in feedback path, so that whenever this diode will conduct, it will closes the feedback path. And this arrangement is nothing but a unity gain amplifier. Means whenever diode conducts, this op amp will act as a voltage follower. Its gain is equal to 1. That is, V0 is equal to Vin. Okay. Now we'll consider the input signal V in for the first positive half cycle. What happens here? For the first positive half cycle of the input signal, as it is given to non-inverting, there is no inversion. So this output voltage is positive, and this will make the diode to forward bias, and it will conduct. So diode D1 conducts, and this will closes the feedback path. So output voltage V0 is nothing but is equal to Vin, because this is voltage follower, gain is equal to 1. Okay, so that whatever is the input will be available at the output. So positive half cycle will get rectified, and we got the rectified output here. Okay, so now during the negative half cycle, this voltage at the output of op amp is negative, and this will make diode in reverse bias. So V0, this opens the feedback path. So output of op amp is at some saturation level, that is, it will goes to the negative saturation, and output voltage available is 0. There is no output available at this across the load resistor RL. So in this case, what happens is op amp will switch into the conduction when diode is in forward bias, and it will goes into the saturation when diode is in reverse bias condition. So that for this purpose, we require a very fast switching operational amplifier, such that it can switch from saturation level into the conduction level. Okay. So now during the negative half cycle, output voltage is 0. There is no output voltage. Again, for the next coming positive half cycle, diode conducts and closes the feedback path. So output voltage is equal to Vin. We know that for non-inverting amplifier, gain equation is 1 plus RF by R1 into Vin, that is, to the non-inverting input terminal. Here feedback resistor is 0, there is no resistance, R1 is open circuited, so gain this factor is equal to 1. Therefore V0 is equal to Vin, and we got output. Whatever is the input peak amplitude will be available at the output. In this way we can rectify the positive half cycle of the input signal also. In inverting, we have rectified the negative half cycle. In non-inverting, we rectified the positive half cycle. You can see both. Here, negative half cycle will get rectified at the output, which is positive half cycle, with inverting configuration. Input is given to the inverting input terminal. Whereas, in non-inverting, input is given to non-inverting input terminal. This is what about the precision half-wave rectifiers. Now, what we want is, we want both the cycles of input signal has to be get rectified. For that purpose, we have to design a full wave rectifier circuit. Okay, here you can see that there is some of the rectifier circuit with two op amps we have designed. So initially, we look only to the circuit diagram of full wave rectifier. Okay, so what we did is, there are two op amps, op amp A1 and A2. Input signal Vin is given to the inverting input terminal, non-inverting terminal is grounded. Okay, now here is output. At output, there are two diodes we have conducted, diode DP and DN. Through diode DP, we have again given input to the inverting input terminal through feedback resistor RF. Again, output of DN is also provided to the first op amp input to the inverting input terminal through resistor RF. And again, what we can see that this is given to the input as well as to the input of second op amp. Okay, here one thing we have to keep in mind, that all the resistors RI, RF and R should be of same value, such that we got output V0 is equal to VI. Rectified output with same amplitude we got at the output. Okay. So this notifications of diode will be given according to which cycle they are conducting at the output. Okay. So now we consider how this will work first. For positive half cycle of the input, according to the waveform, we can easily find this how it will work. First, for the positive half cycle of the input, that is given to the inverting input terminal. Okay. Now we are providing input positive half cycle, that is given to the inverting input terminal. Output at this point is 180 degree phase shift. Sum of the for first positive half cycle, negative output will be available. So this negative output will make diode DP forward biases and diode D1 reverse biases. So diode DP conducts. Okay. So this will conduct and it will closes the feedback path. And now what should be the output is RF by R1 into Vin. We know that this resistor is R and this is R. So what should be the gain? Gain is equal to 1. So whatever is the Vin will be available here because of the gain is equal to 1. And this Vin, this diode conducts, it will also closes the feedback path, as well as this will make the output voltage available at the input of second op amp. So this Vin voltage, or we can call this one as VA, which is equal to Vin. VA is again given to the inverting input terminal of second op amp. Okay. Now this input voltage, what is it? It is negative half cycle. Initially we are providing positive half cycle. This is given to the inverting input terminal. So this will act as inverter. Positive will get inverted, negative half cycle will be available here. So that negative we are providing to the again inverting input terminal. This op amp will also act as an inverter. Okay. So what happens is both op amps A1 as well as A2 will act as inverters, and so that the negative input available to the second op amp will get inverted. So at last at the output we got positive half cycle. Okay. So positive half cycle get inverted at the output of first op amp. This will available as input. Again this will invert. So negative half cycle again get inverted. And as all resistors are same, gain of this op amp is 1. Also gain of this op amp is 1. So what happens is, because of which both A1 and A2 will act as inverters. And so that we got positive half cycle at the output. Now we consider the second cycle, negative half cycle of the input. What happens to this? So basically for this we have to go for some of the calculations. Initially for the negative half cycle, here we got positive output because 180 degree phase shift, inversion of the signal. Positive output will be available here. This will make diode D1 to conduct. So diode DN conducts and DP is in reverse bias. So there is no open circuit. So this is simply open circuited. Okay. So DN conducts, this will make the output available to the inverting input terminal, means again this op amp will have some feedback path, and this voltage is also available at input to the second op amp, that is to the non-inverting input terminal. And this voltage is nothing but VA. This will act as inverter, but this is non-inverting amplifier. We'll see its equivalent circuit diagram and then you will get exact idea about it, how this circuit will work. Okay. So now for the negative half cycle of input. Okay. Negative input we are providing. This is what diode DN conducts, and through the resistor R, this feedback will closes the loop. This diode is open circuited, so there is no connection, so that this resistor R and this resistor R are in series. So R plus R, we got equivalent resistance of twice of R. This resistor is in feedback with second op amp R2. Now what happens is, here VA voltage is present. We have to calculate the current to this node N. What should be the current to this node N? Because of VI, I1 is current. So how we can define this as VI by R, that is current through resistor R. VA voltage is available to the non-inverting input terminal. And by the virtual ground concept, we know that input at one terminal is equal to the input at another terminal. That is, because of differential input voltage is equal to 0, V1 is equal to V2. V1 is input at non-inverting, V2 is input at inverting. If this is VA, voltage at this point is also VA. Okay. So, because of this, there is another current I3 flowing to node N. This current I3 is nothing but what is voltage at here is VA. VA by resistance, that is twice of R. So, current I3 is VA divided by 2R. Another current I2 is flowing to this node. That is because of diode DN conducts. Okay. So, because of this diode DN conducts, there is some current, that is I2. So, this current we are defining as VA by R. Very simple, that we can easily find out its equation here, how this will work. So, now we have to write the KCL equation here. So, first put circuit in front of us, that is when negative half cycle is input, how this circuit will work. At node, we have to write the KCL. When we are writing KCL at node, that is I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to 0. That is, all the current to the node is equal to 0. What is I1? I1 is VI by R. What is I2? It is VA by R. And I3 is VA by twice of R. And all is equal to 0. Okay, now for VA, we have taken VA by R as common. So, coefficient is 1 plus 1 by 2. We got it is VI by R plus VA by R into 3 by 2. Okay. Now, solving for this VA, because this is input to the non-inverting input terminal. So, we have to find out the value of VA. So, VA is nothing but after solving for this, we got VA is minus of 2 by 3. That is here VI by R is equal to minus VA by R into 3 by 2, and then rearrange this, we got minus of 2 by 3 into VA. So, this is nothing but VA voltage. So, what we have to consider is, this is nothing but input to non-inverting input terminal. Now, we have to write the equation for non-inverting amplifier. Why? Because for negative half cycle output, we have to find out. And for non-inverting amplifier, output voltage equation V0 is 1 plus RF by R1 into VA. VA is input. Why 1 plus RF by R1? 1 plus RF is resistor R. R1 is this resistor, twice of R, into VA. Okay. So, VA is nothing but minus 2 by 3 into VI. That already we got here, minus 2 by 3 into VI. RF and R1 are nothing but RF is equal to R and R1 is equal to twice of R. So that we have selected value of RF is equal to R and R1 is equal to twice of R. That is V0 is equal to 1 plus R by 2R into bracket minus 2 by 3 into V of I. Okay. So what happens is now RR we can cancel here. So, it is 2, 1's are 2 plus 1 divided by 2, 3 by 2 into minus of 2 by 3 VI. 2, 2 will get cancelled and 3, 3 will also get cancelled. What is output voltage? Output voltage is equal to minus of VI. Okay. So, what happens is during negative half cycle, again we got output voltage is equal to minus of VI. Okay. What is VI? VI is negative half cycle. So, negative of negative, we got positive half cycle at the output. See here, V0 is minus of VI. What is VI? Is negative half cycle. So, what should be our output voltage? V0 is equal to minus of negative half cycle. So, positive half cycle will be the output voltage. So, during negative half cycle, what we got? Positive output. Positive half cycle, that is rectified output voltage will be available at the output. Positive half cycle we got initially because both will act as inverter. Positive will get inverted, negative half cycle will be available here. Then again this will act as inverter. So, it will again invert the negative to positive. So, positive half cycle will be available. During negative we got here how this will be working. and accordingly we have find VA is input minus 2 by 3 into VI to the second op amp, and for this we have written the output voltage equation 1 plus RF by R1, and that is again we got its gain is equal to 3 by 2 and input is minus 2 by 3 into VI. So output is V0 is equal to minus of VI. So original input signal VI is negative, and so that output is positive half cycle, rectified positive half cycle will be available at the output. So this is nothing but a full wave rectification we got here, that is positive will get also rectified and negative cycle also get rectified here. In this way, even a signal which is less than 0.7 volt will get rectified. Diodes will work as a rectifier element here, but because of the operational amplifier and its very high gain values, we can rectify small signals into, or we can also rectify the signals which are less than 0.7 volts here. So this is nothing but a full wave rectifier. Its circuit, two op amps we have used, and with the help of two diodes, one will conduct for positive half cycle, another will conduct negative half cycle, and resistors are selected such that its gain is equal to 1 when it will act as inverter, and its gain for the second half cycle, negative half cycle, gain of second op amp will give us the same amplitude as the input at output. Okay, so what we got is V0 is equal to again positive half cycle at the output. In this way, both the cycles, positive as well as negative cycle, will get rectified here. So this is nothing but a precision rectifier. This will be used for communication purposes and for many more applications here. Thank you.